Hey guys, I'm Scarlett from Miss Money, and if you haven't guessed it already from the title, I'm really excited about AMC right now. This is an update from my last video, and I'll explain why I am even more bullish about AMC and convinced that you're missing out if you haven't already got in. Additionally, I'll update you on my new price prediction and analysis. I have a lot of game-changing news I want to share with you all about AMC. AMC shares gained 14% with New York City set to reopen theaters Friday after a year dark. There's a bearish article I read regarding AMC, and I'm going to refute some of the key things I read in there. You're going to love what I have for you guys today. But first, I would love it if you subscribe to the channel, press that notification bell, and be part of the family of winners here. Let's dive in. Just take a glance at the price action over the last few days. It's been insane here. Look at this craziness going on as it's consolidating at around $9 a share, which I think is a very good thing. We had this really nice run up after consolidating a while at the $5.50 range, and then a bit of a sell-off at that $8.01 price point. And since then, we've been pretty stagnant around an $8, $9 per share. And I wanna break down exactly why I think we could see some massive price action for AMC. It's hard to guess when this will happen, so I'll be sure to follow it closely to predict the best guess. So AMC did announce they're gonna release their fourth quarter earnings March 10th, so be on the lookout. You know, obviously this year the movie industry took a blow, so I wouldn't expect amazing numbers, guys. And if you remember my last video, I talked about how people have been enjoying the video on demand with Disney Plus, HBO Max, all that. Well, a recent article came out and the CEO of Disney shared his views on post-pandemic theatrical releases. And he said, quote, "The consumer is probably more impatient than they've ever been before, particularly since now they've had the luxury of an entire year of getting titles at home pretty much when they want. So I'm not sure there is going back, but we certainly don't want to do anything like cut the legs off a theatrical exhibition run." So breaking it down, he goes on to say later that Disney, they plan to shorten theatrical releases post-pandemic. And we all know, you know, Disney someday could possibly run the world. But I don't see this as a necessarily bad thing for AMC. In fact, it might bring back the rush of seeing a movie as soon as it is released in the theaters. I'm a huge movie buff and I love the history of the movie industry. And one of the big things in the history of movies is that the studios used to own the theaters, but it became a conflict of interest, and that's when theater chains began opening, so the studios wouldn't hold all the power. Unfortunately, timing and duration of release is a power, and this is a big play for Disney. This is just something to keep in mind as you invest in AMC. I think it's just Disney controlling their IP and releasing it on their streaming service, Disney Plus. But let's get into the exciting news for AMC, guys. Recently, AMC Entertainment shares ended the last trading session 14.6% higher at $9.18. The jump came on an impressive volume with a higher than average number of shares changing hands in the session. This compares to the stock's 7.2% loss over the past 4 weeks. Approval of bonuses to its top executives and eligible employees boosted investors' confidence. Moreover, and as I've been telling you guys, the reopening of theaters in New York definitely helped. This movie theater operator is expected to post the quarterly loss of $3.39 per share in its upcoming report, which represents a year-over-year change of, sadly, negative 1,068.6%. Revenues are expected to be around $181 million, down 87.5% from the year-ago quarter. Earnings and revenue growth expectations certainly give a good sense of the potential strength in a stock, but research shows that trends in earnings estimate revisions are strongly correlated with near-term stock price movements. But media in general is making a comeback after a rough year. After this pandemic, I believe we'll see some bounce back. Live Nation shares rose nearly 5%. CEO Michael Rapino said Friday during an earnings call, citing conversations with state governors, that a clear outline has emerged for a 75% to 100% capacity reopening for outdoor U.S. events this year. the giant venue operator, also sold out tickets to two large UK festivals in August. Classic media and entertainment stocks are also buoyant and may be time to note an ongoing mood shift around companies as they make strides in streaming. Many have also posted better than expected quarterly results in advertising and other metrics after the horrific impact of COVID-19. AMC Networks CEO Josh Sapan also impressed the street on Friday, beating earnings estimates, disclosing over 6 million year-end streaming subscribers and anticipating 20 million to 25 million in 2025. He thinks AMC Nets and others have Disney to thank. Wonder about that. So after a massive re-rating of growth equities and COVID winners, AMC and many other media peers had been left for dead. Then in December, after another successful investor day in which Disney laid out its DTC ambitions, the market's complete shift to some of the parts valuation methodology at Disney opened the door for investors to try this approach on other companies. Also recently, shares of Pluto parent ViacomCBS are up 5%, with Paramount Plus launching this week. Tubi owner Fox is up 5%. Lionsgate expanding in streaming with Stars is up about 7%. Fubo is up 7% as it prepares to report earnings this week. It didn't hurt Monday's markets that Berkshire Hathaway's Warren Buffett, the 90-year-old, you know, Oracle of Omaha, urged over the weekend in his closely studied annual shareholders letter, never bet against America. And what is more American than the movies and entertainment? So my new price prediction for AMC for the short term is $20, but for the long term, I think AMC will still go to the moon post-pandemic, possibly even hitting $50 per share. So hang in there, get in if you're not already. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm Scarlett from Miss Money, and let's invest and get successful together.